15,201, sold out, largest crowd for an event yet to take place in this building. That means a bigger crowd than a year ago when Manny Pacquiao headlined the pay-per-view card against Brandon Rios here in the same arena. There are also 1,000 people watching on closed circuit, as we call it, in an adjoining room. So 14,000 plus live today in Macau, along with all of those of you in the United States who are watching on Saturday night.
Now against Salido, who is a big pressure fighter, we saw Lomachenko get better as the fight wore on, as though he became more energetic in the second half of the fight. Here, though, he's fought at a faster pace early, much more offensive-minded early. We'll see what happens if this fight continues on into the second half.
I mentioned it's a strong division, and some of the names have already come up. Lomachenko has a title belt. Johnny Gonzalez has a title belt. Nicholas Walters took one from Nonito Donaire October 18 in Carson, California. Evgeny Gradovich has a title belt, and you'll see him next week on the undercard of the Terrence Crawford fight in Omaha, Nebraska. Hard left hand by Lomachenko up and under. He's landed that shot two or three times to good effect.
And although I agree with Roy that Rigondeaux is his smaller size means Lomachenko's favorite there, that might be the best matchup of all.
Great skill matchup.
And we ever had a chance to see two-time gold medalists fight against one another? We very rarely get to see two gold medalists fight one another.
Who, by the way, both have a chance to be the best pound-for-pound fighter in boxing in the not-too-distant future. Meantime, Aperio Pino still there, still pressuring, still throwing real shots.
You got to give him credit, son. He's taking some real punches tonight, and he keeps coming right back.
Well, not exactly a luxury life for Shunlatan Aperio Pino. Comes from a small town in Thailand. His parents had a farm. They grew vegetables on the farm, sold them or bartered them for the things that they needed. Lomachenko hammering him against the ropes.
Looked like he took his sparring lessons getting kicked by a cow, because he's taking some shots here that have to be almost equivalent to getting kicked by a cow.
A small cow. A featherweight cow.
More like a racehorse, a thoroughbred.
Yeah, that's a good analogy for Lomachenko.
Well, the arms are a little short for a horse, though. That's why I went with the cow.
Aperio Pino got in his left hook to the body and landed it with authority. Every once in a while.